One of the legends of Samoan and Auckland rugby, Peter Fatialofa, has died suddenly this morning at the age of 54. Affectionately known as Peter Fats, he was captain of Manu Samoa during their famous 1991 Rugby World Cup campaign. Andrew Saville now joins us live. Andrew.
Yes, Peter, certainly a sad loss for two nations today, Samoa and also New Zealand, not only because of Peter Fatialofa's playing career in rugby, but also his influence on the wider community. A prouder man never wore the famous blue jersey of Samoa. Peter Fatialofa was their captain for the country's breakthrough international win against Wales at the 1991 World Cup, wearing number one and making the final pass for the match-winning try.
There's numbers here for the Samoans. Must be a try. Yes, no question about this one.
But not really minding his manners for the captain's interview.
We've never played in this kind of crowd before, and shit, you know. It's too much.
But he always had a fun side to him. He was a character, loved life, was a good, really good footballer, but a really good person.
He was a genial, popular man who became one of the first New Zealand-based players to represent the country of his parents' birth, paving the way for the next generation and having a huge influence on Polynesian players.
Fats really led the way, and I think he became a real role model for not just Samoans, but for Polynesian.
As well as his international record, which continued until 1996, he was a stalwart of the Ponsonby Club and of the famous Auckland Ranfurly Shield team of the 1980s and early 90s.
Fatialofa, the big prop forward. He's on his way, and he gets there.
Peter Fats, the unofficial keeper of the log, still had an influence in Samoan rugby today, coaching the women's national team. After playing, Fatialofa became renowned around Auckland for running a piano-moving business. Like its owner, the workers and company are still larger than life. Peter Fatialofa is survived by his wife and eight children. The beaming smile will always be remembered. And the tributes and memories are sure to flow for days to come. We've just had this message in from Auckland Rugby Union board member and Peter Fats' former Auckland captain and All Black lock, Gary Whetton. Gary says he was the ultimate team man, was Peter Fats. On the field, he was huge, and off the field, such a gentleman. I'm so sad for Anne and his family. We have all lost a brilliant man. Now, Peter Fats died suddenly this morning in the Samoan Islands, aged 54. He had a tour company named Fats Tours. He loved showing tourists from all around the world the islands he so loved. A man who lived life to the fullest. He will be sorely missed.